Anger and anguish mixed today as hundreds of people gathered to mourn two little boys and their mother who drowned last week on the other side of the world. A picture of three-year-old Alan Kurdi's lifeless body on a beach in Turkey has sparked outrage across the globe. Today, the boy's aunt held a memorial service in downtown Vancouver. As the CBC's Megan Batchelor reports, the mourners hope these deaths bring change for thousands of other refugees.
It's an image that sparked outrage. Today, that emotion was taken over by despair and mourning over the deaths of Alan Kurdi and his brother Galib and mother Rehana, and thoughts of support for Abdullah, the father and husband who survived after an overcrowded boat capsized.
Oh God, we failed to help a child in need. We refused him at our shores, so you gave him a better place. Forgive us for our shortcomings and help us be the change that we so desperately want to see.
Hundreds gathered here who wanted to honor the memory of the little boy whose death is at the center of worldwide outrage. Mourners heard of his mother Rehana's beauty, inside and out, and of Galib and Alan, including their love of bananas, a treat for the family who couldn't afford food.
Abdullah told Tima that he wants to go next to his sons and lay there and buy a banana every day and split it and put it on their grave.
Heartbreaking stories from a family struggling to come to grips with lives lost too soon.
The first thing I said to him, I'm so sorry. It was my fault. Because I sent him the money to pay the smuggler and to cross that water. I thought if I didn't send him the money, they could be alive today.
The vessel carrying refugees capsized last week, killing dozens on board. Today, anger over the deaths and a call for action.
Millions of refugees, Kurdish, Arab, Christian, Yazidi, and other minorities have been crying out to the world. But nobody listened until Alan's little body surfaced.
Balloons were released one by one in honor of the three lost, as thoughts now turn to the many other thousands still desperate for refuge. Megan Batchelor, CBC News, Vancouver.